Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Dungeon. I'm your host, Loren Tepper. Well, today, I know it's summertime, but we're talking football! Are you ready? We got the Arkansas Cowboys. This is an amateur football team right here in Harrison, Arkansas. These guys are out here to help promote their team. They're looking for players, sponsors, volunteers, you name it, they want you. Come on out. They're going to be playing this year out at Goblin Stadium. First home game is going to be sometime in mid-June. They've already played one. They beat the boys up from Oklahoma. They're going to be playing this weekend down in Little Rock. These guys are here. They're excited, and they want to talk some football. That's what I like to see. Let's talk about some other things going on in sports this past week. It was the athletic banquet over at Goblin Stadium. Big John Colliver was the big winner on the boys' side. Congratulations to Big John. He's also signed a national letter of intent to go to Southwest Baptist to play football and basketball. Yes, he's going to two-sport it up there in Bolivar. Southwest Baptist has got a steal and probably one of the best athletes in this graduating class of seniors to come out of Harrison in a long, long time. This is a three-star sport athlete. He was All-State in football, basketball, and soccer. This guy is a true athlete, and Southwest Baptist is getting a steal in Big John Colliver. Some other athletes who are going to sign letters of intent and have already moved on. Big old Nick Wayman, the 6'8" guy down at Valley Springs, going to go play at Arkansas Tech. As well as, on the girls' side, Ariel Saunders is going to go play for the Bison at Harding University. Those were all reported earlier in the year. But later on here in the year, we've got also Blake Air McNair. He's going over to play at Harding as well. It ought to be exciting down in Searcy as the Bison have two big-name basketball stars from this community. You know what? It's exciting to see those guys moving on and their athletic prowess. You know, also out at North Arkansas College, though, on the women's side, the Lady Pioneers have signed four local players. Jana Case, the Alpena Leopard, the 6'2" gal in the middle, who is the big shot blocker, is going to take her time and continue her playing time over as a Lady Pioneer. Also, they got the two gals from the Bergman Lady Panthers, Chelsea Johnson and Destiny Prohaska. Those two is a 1-2 punch for the Bergman Panthers. Ought to be exciting to see them play over at Pioneer Pavilion. And fourth, but sure not last, she's a gal who can shoot it from anywhere on the floor. She can beat you on the dribble. We're talking about the Yellow Jacket herself, Brooke Poole. You remember I had her on the show. She guaranteed a state title run in Class 1A girls. She came close to fulfilling her promise. You know what? She is a heck of a player. Been watching her play since her freshman year on the varsity level at Kingston, and she is going to add another dimension to Coach Stacy Klotz's team. I can't wait for November 1st to get here so I can be out there at Pioneer Pavilion to watch those Lady Pioneers go on. And I know Shorty Osier, he'd be calling the haw. That's for you, Shorty Osier. Well, we'll take a short break. We're going to come back. We're going to talk football with the Arkansas Cowboys. We'll be right back.